We're going to do a few examples on negative exponents. First thing to keep in mind is that negative exponents don't have anything to do with making a number negative. It simply means take the reciprocal. So you drop the negative and take the reciprocal every time. For example, x to the negative 3 is equal to 1 over x cubed. Another example using a base of 3, 3 over negative 2 is 1 over 3 squared, which is 1 over 9. If we have a negative exponent in the numerator and in the denominator, all we do is drop the negative on the numerator and bring it to the denominator, and we drop the negative on the denominator and bring it to the numerator. So we take the reciprocal of both. We can extend this. If we have 2x, the whole thing raised to the negative 2 power, that's equal to 1 over 2x, the quantity squared, which is 1 over 4x squared. We can apply the rules as usual and deal with the negatives at the end. For example, x to the negative 4, y cubed, all raised to the fifth power. By exponent rules, we get x to the negative 20th, y to the 15th. Right now, both of these factors are written in the numerator, so we will drop the negative and bring it to the denominator, leaving y to the 15th over x to the 20th as our final answer here. We'll do a similar problem where the exponent is negative, x to the negative 4, y cubed, all raised to the negative 5 power. Now you can take the reciprocal right now, but we're still going to have negatives, so it would be easier to just distribute first x to the 20th power, y to the negative 15th power. X has a positive exponent, stays in the numerator, but the y we bring down to the denominator. For our next example, we can have x to the 8th, y cubed, over x to the 10th, y squared. When we're dividing like bases, we subtract the exponents. So this is equal to x to the 8 minus 10 times y to the 3 minus 2, which equals x to the negative 2, y to the 1st. Once again, we drop the negative, bring it to the denominator. We get y over x squared as our final answer here. We can have x to the 8th, x to the 10th, y cubed over y squared, the same exact problem, let's say raised to the negative 3rd power. We always do order of ops, so we can simplify inside first, as we did in the last problem. And if we do, we have x to the negative 2 times y, all raised to the negative 3 power. If we distribute, we get x to the 6th power, y to the negative 3. Keep the x in the numerator, bring the y to the denominator, and we have our answer. Next example is going to have some constants, so make sure you know not to keep them, not to do anything different when you've got a negative exponent. So we will do this problem. We distribute and we get negative 2. I meant to do to the negative 3 power. Negative 2 raised to the negative 3, x to the negative 9, y to the negative 3, over 3 raised to the negative 3, and z raised to the negative 3. So I'm writing everything out here. Now we can simply reverse everything if we'd like to. That means that everything will reverse. What's in the denominator goes to the numerator as 3 cubed, z cubed. Negative 2, keep that negative, cubed, x to the 9th, y cubed. And all we have to do now is just compute the numbers. 3 cubed is 27, z cubed. Over, when we raise a negative to an odd power, we get negative 8, x to the 9th, y cubed. We want to see if we can reduce, but we can't on this problem.